Speaking of large tax bills, name the best paid sportsman of all time.
Oh, so it's not going to be one of those. Well, it's not going to
I was going to say one of those. Ah. I'm say that one on the left.
Is it?
Where are you?
Is it? Going
no,
to...
not the best laid.
No, I actually didn't.
Top crime from Alan Davies.
It's all crime, yeah. Absolutely.
Is it of all time, Dolly? So
of all time, yeah.
So it's going to be relative, so it's going to be someone in ancient Greece or someone in
Spartacus.
Imperial Rome.
Imperial Rome is indeed where we need to be, yeah.
Is it a gladiator of some sort?
Not a gladiator, a charioteer. A charioteer by the name of Gaius Apuleius Diocles. And he was a Lusitanian Spaniard, and he was the greatest sportsman of his age.
He wasn't a looker, though, was he?
Well, that may not be accurate, but we know he won.
That's a photograph.
judging the horses. After a while, you do turn into a little bit like the animal that you work with.
Yeah. Yes. He won 1,462 races, which racked up 35,863,120 sesterces in prize money. And it's recorded in a monumental inscription, exactly that amount. It's called the Champion of All Charioteers. And if you compare this to the average wage of the day and use all the calculations that people used to determine these things, his career winnings amounted to an equivalent of $15 billion. Quite an astonishing amount of money. This was in 146 AD that he retired as the richest sportsman. And they had four horses, and there were up to 12 teams, and they would go round a lap like Ben Hur there. And the skill was the cornering. It was incredibly difficult. Well, and he won, as I say, nearly 1,500 races, don't you?
Because Nero used to race in chariot races, and he always won everything.
Yeah,
but what used to happen, there's one occasion apparently when he fell out of the chariot, and everybody stopped and pretended that their horse had got something wrong with them. Having a look. Is he back in? And then he got back in and he won.
God.
Yeah.
Is it true or is it a myth that the people were killed in the filming and...
The original Ben-Hur, the silent one, I think people killed in that, in the previous version, and that...
In the silent one, they're going
but you
at
couldn't
phenomenal
hear them.
Speed.
Yes, very, very fast. And nobody minded in those days.
No, you couldn't hear a thing.
No, quite. Do you know... Do you know the connection between Ben-Hur and Billy the Kid? Well, do you know who wrote Ben-Hur, the novel?
I feel like I did know it, and I don't.
But he's a man called Wallace, and he was the governor of New Mexico. And he was the one who signed Billy the Kid's death warrant.
So the, Ooh, that's fabulous trivia.
Isn't it?
Yeah, well done you. I think you should get an extra point for that. Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.